step into a new realm. Welcome to Realms of Healing with your host, Akashic Intuitive, Gabriel Llewellyn-Ari.
Welcome to Realms of Healing. My name is Gabriel Llewellyn-Ari, and I get the privilege to be with you for the next hour, exploring with you, within yourself, with me, going on this sacred and beautiful journey together of deep healing into all the different realms. Oh gosh, I just have to say that I am so excited. I've been very busy, as many of you know, working on Realms Radio, creating this platform for inspiration 24/7, creating a new community of people on planet Earth through the technology that we have. So I've been very, very, very busy getting new archives up and new shows and helping people who don't even have shows on Realms Radio yet get their shows on here, and I want to share my profound gratitude for that, and for you as a listener. Thank you for listening and for supporting Realms Radio. That you are the reason that we are doing this. You're the entire whole reason that we are coming together here and talking and utilizing our gifts. It's for you. So thanks again for listening. I do have some exciting announcements real quick before we get into our topic, which I am so excited to get into, so I'll make it real brief. We are raising funds for Realms Radio to go live. So what that means is that we will be able to take your calls, so you can call into my show and you can talk with me. I can give you a reading. You can call into Lizzie V. Love and Anushi Asta and talk with them. And we're raising funds, and we don't really need much at all. In fact, all we need is $888, and then we can do it. And then we'll be live from then on out. And what we'll also get with this, in addition to being able to take your calls, is we will also be able to play any music. So music by Celine Dion or Shakira or Madonna or anything that's inspirational, we will be able to play, and we will play. So that's one thing that is a very important part. Both of those things are very important parts of the vision. That's a good word, isn't it? Combine vision and mission. Why not? And so that's something that we are really excited about, because it will really help Realms Radio to move into what it really always has been, which is a platform of inspiration and empowerment and healing and love and all this stuff. It'll just be the more full and complete version of that, which I'm so excited about. So I invite you to help us donating whatever you'd like to donate, even if it's just your prayers. That's great. We love and accept that. That really helps us. And we're also excited because we have created this thing called the Abundance Vortex, which basically means that whatever you put into this project or anything that Realms Radio is involved with, it's blessed by all of our practitioners. 10 times whatever you put in will come back to you. So it's well worth your time and your money, even if it's just $1 or $5, because it will come back to you. We affirm that, and it works. It works, it works, it works. So please do that, and please be on the lookout also for some new shows coming up. I won't tell you just I'm gonna be like a parent teasing you with candy right now. I won't tell you about the shows, but I'll tell you that we have new shows debuting shortly. So definitely stay tuned and keep on the lookout for that. I'm really excited about our topic here today. Today we're talking about awakening your intuition through dietary changes. And we're going to be discussing a lot of different foods that you can begin to incorporate into your diet, and also foods that you may want to think twice about eating, especially if you want to be intuitive. And of course, this isn't going to be a show about this is a certain diet that you need to live by and this is the way of things. It's really not that. It's just sharing with you my personal experience being a professional intuitive and doing this for a living for, geez, gosh, a couple years. And really honing this skill personally for myself, and the foundation that I discovered for that was really my diet. I began to see that when my diet was not in alignment with me, basically, my intuition really started to suffer. And I didn't give as accurate of readings, and I didn't show up how I normally did. And so what I discovered is when my diet was really on, and I ate a certain way, and I was really committed to that, especially just the day that I was giving readings, it would take my intuition to a whole other level that previously I hadn't even known existed. So that's what we're going to be talking about today, and so let's get into today's topic, and I will introduce it right now. So today we are talking about awakening your intuition through changing your diet. There are so many different ways of eating, and they're all individualized perfectly and harmonized magnificently for you, individually for you. And it's very important initially to trust yourself. Please listen to what I say, listen to what other people in the field of nutrition might say, but really listen to your core and your gut and what your intuition is telling you about what to eat and when to eat. It's very important to note that when our bodies are in perfect harmony, when we are in radiant health, we naturally exude and are able to receive divine guidance. It comes through us, it comes to us, it comes as us. Because our bodies live here on Earth, or they're made of the Earth, and our souls are etheric, there's a bridging that needs to happen. It's almost like living with your body is living with a roommate. If you are taking care of your house and doing your part for taking responsibility for the things that you need to take responsibility for in your living situation, your roommate will be happy. You'll have a good relationship as long as they're doing their part. And the same is true in reference to your body. If you give your body what it needs, if you really honor it, if you really go deep and remain committed to your own vibrant health, your body is going to take your soul here on planet Earth where your soul wants to go. And conversely, if your soul is wanting to go and do all this stuff and be inspired and have all this energy, and your body is sick, it will severely limit you. And that's why health, in my personal opinion, is the foundation for all success. It is the foundation for life. When your health improves, your entire life improves. Isn't that great? Your entire life will improve just by doing one simple thing. By changing your health, changing your diet, changing your exercise plan. Because again, when our bodies are happy, when they're feeling good, they give us the energy to carry out our divine purpose. And sometimes for some of us, it's really just that simple to get. Like, we have every other area of our life mastered, except for our health, and that's affecting every area of our life. And so just really being very committed to taking care of yourself, taking care of your body, taking care of your mind, and taking care of your spirit. It's holistic. And so today what we're going to focus on is we're going to focus on the body aspect, because that is where so many of us get stopped and get tripped up, possibly and probably because we just don't know. We just don't know any better. And we want to be intuitive. We want these natural abilities to flow to us. We know that we have them. We're aware that we have them. We want to increase naturally the gifts that we have already. And yet we live in a society and in a culture that's very addictive based. And so we naturally gravitate towards things that cause us to shut down our intuition. And our culture helps us, our culture really creates a wonderful container for that. And so it's very easy to get into a habit of shutting off your intuition and becoming addicted to things. And we talked about this in the last show on forgiveness, the pathway to forgiveness, which you can check out at the archives on realmzradio.net. And it's really important to remember that. And so today, that's what we're talking about. We're talking about how to get back in touch, how to tap back in, using your diet as the foundation for that. Of course, there's a lot more than just changing your diet, but that's the foundation. That's the foundation. So let's talk about foods. Ooh, 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 ooh. What foods awaken intuition? What foods stop it? Am I eating the right way to allow my natural intuition to blossom, or am I simply eating whatever I want and I'm not really feeling that intuitive? I don't really know when something's on or not. And one thing that I'll say is that it's really crucial to remember that intuition does take practice too. So if you just change your diet and expect your intuition to just be there when it never has been, well, it will be easier to access. It'll be much easier for you to access, actually. But it's not the only thing that you need to do. You also need to practice your intuition, practice being still, and allowing spirit to commune with you. Then changing your diet will augment that and help you to get in touch with that still small voice that resides deep within you, inside of your heart. And so this isn't a right way or a wrong way kind of thing, or this is the only path that you need to do. Of course not. There's many people who are very powerful and very intuitive, and they eat whatever they want, and that's great. I will say, though, that if you listen to what I say and you take guidance and start to begin to implement these things into your life, no matter what level of intuition that you're at, your intuition will improve. I guarantee this. I have seen it over and over with clients or people in my life that I've recommended this to. So it's definitely tested and it works. So, what is a diet that fosters intuition? So basically, in a nutshell, and I'll explain a lot more about this as we go into the show, but in a nutshell, if you take one thing away from this show, Listen up. This is it. Eating the way that you would eat in nature. If you were out wandering the woods in the or the jungles or wherever you were, how would you eat? Would you see some refined sugar sitting on a rock and start eating that? Or would you see a mango in a tree and be naturally drawn to go and pick it due to its beautiful color? Would you see a rabbit and get excited to eat it just by seeing the rabbit? Would you say, yum, that looks so good? Or would you smell the smell of the pineapples blowing in the breeze that excites your senses right there? It's just really important to think about that and to gravitate. Well, what would, if I was out in nature, what would I generally want to eat? Would I be drawn to it? And keeping in mind, remember that humans, we're designed to live in a tropical environment. So our bodies and what we're here to do is designed to really live outside in a tropical environment. So if you were out in paradise, what would you eat? Would you eat bananas? You know, what would you be naturally drawn to? Or would you see a fish and want to eat that? Maybe. I don't know. But we're going to talk about that today, and it's going to be an exciting talk. So with that, there are definitely many, many foods in our society now that are not natural. You probably can even think of some right now on your food shelf that are just, that you would never see that out in nature. Even if it's natural, even if it's a natural thing, like oil. Oil, you would never find oil in nature. Even though it's inside of the nut or it's inside of the olive, you would never just come upon a vat of oil and be able to drink it. Like, yummy. No, you would find the olive and you would eat the olive, or you would eat the almond, you would eat the seed that had the oil in it, along with all of the other components. So it's really starting to think about that and what you would eat. Now, and again, in our society today, there's everything from chemicals to extractions to soy lecithin to monosodium glutamate, which is never found in nature, of course. It's man-made. And so this is really something that I want you to think about, is where in your life and what kind of food are you eating that really might not be that natural? Do you eat foods with dye in it sometimes, or pesticides, or things that are refined that would never, ever, ever be that way in nature? So, let's start with the foods that turn off intuition. So what foods halt intuition? What foods stop the intuitive process completely, cloud the chakras, and really start to allow a disjointedness to happen? Well, I will tell you. I will tell you right here. So first things are all animal foods, and I'm not gonna go into a big long diatribe about you need to be vegan and woohoo. I mean, I'm not vegan. I'm mostly, though. I don't eat meat, but I occasionally might indulge in some cheese or something like that, but very occasionally, maybe like once or twice a month, if that. And I found that my body doesn't really even want it anymore, so it's getting easier. So I'm not advocating for vegan or saying that that's the way everyone needs to be. However, eating animal products, especially red meat, out of all the animal products, is the number one way to turn off your intuition. And red meat, as many of us know, just, gosh, it sits in our guts and it rots. It rots there. And in fact, all meat, whether it's fish or shellfish or anything, will rot in our intestines because From what I've read, I'm not claiming that this is the truth, but from what I've read in lots of different books, we have the intestines of an herbivore. And so our intestines are made for fiber, and they're long, and they're windy. And a carnivore's intestines are, they're straight. So after a carnivore eats, it usually goes to the bathroom very quickly. That's why, like, a dog, after a dog eats, it usually needs to go poop right away. It's because it's digesting it so fast and getting it out so quickly that it has to go. So the meat doesn't rot in its body, and that's what it does in our bodies, is it rots, which that then causes a state in the body of toxicity. And not only that, but meat leaves a very acidic ash in the body, and you can go on, you can Google the effects of the harmful effects of eating meat for our bodies, and check that out. Or even if you do want to eat meat, just really maybe thinking about limiting it. Or if you want to be more intuitive, like to give a reading or something, maybe the day before, a couple days, and the day of, to not eat meat. And to just think about that. So we're not making yourself wrong. You're not making yourself wrong. I'm not making you wrong. I love everyone. I just want everyone to have some knowledge if they like. So meat and dairy and eggs is the first one that really shuts off intuition. The next piece of foods that shut down intuition are refined foods. So anything like white flour or sugar or, gosh, just anything that's refined. Not so much oil, but anything that's been stripped of its nutrients and that's just kind of like filler will do that. Also, processed foods, you know, like, because they're so unnatural and they have all these preservatives and just gunk that you would never eat will shut off intuition too. Things like dyes, pesticides will turn it off in a big way if you eat too many of those. And drugs, of course. so anything that's not really naturally supposed to be in your body will tamper with your intuition, or anything that alters your brain chemicals, like drugs, pharmaceutical drugs, or psychedelic drugs, will shut off your intuition. And that's why people get addicted to them, is because that's the whole premise of addictions, by the way, is stopping and numbing your divine guidance. So if your divine guidance is saying, hey girl, go out there and be a public speaker, like you can do it, and you're all shy and you're thinking, I can't do it, and what you do to turn that voice off temporarily is you will create some kind of addiction, whether it's sex or it is food or it's drugs or it's negative thinking or overworking or whatever it is. That's what our society has used to turn off our intuition. And we're not trying to do that here. We're actually trying to turn it on. So this process can actually be kind of triggering, because you're going to be turning your intuition on more, and so you're going to be getting more messages about what you need to be doing and when you need to be doing it. And a lot of us are very used to shutting that off. So just really encourage you to allow this process to happen naturally, and don't do all this at once. Just take it one step at a time, and allow yourself to grow. So with that, another food that a lot of us love, in fact, it's the number one, people will say this, this next food I'm going to tell you about is the number one most craved food in the world. You know what it is? What is the most craved food in the world? It's chocolate, cacao. Yes, and I will say that chocolate definitely will turn off your intuition. Chocolate has many health properties that are very great, especially raw cacao, which is how it's pronounced. chocolate is when it's made into, when it's melted and it's added, you know, sugars added to it. Cacao is the plant. The cacao pods are what are used to make chocolate. So cacao is in chocolate. Chocolate is not in cacao. So I'll just say cacao. So cacao is a incredible plant from South America, and it has a lot of superfood properties. It's really rich in iron and magnesium, which a lot of people are low on, and that's one reason why a lot of people crave chocolate, just because their body knows that it can get those two minerals from chocolate and cacao, and they're not found a lot in our diets, with the exception of meat, which does contain iron. But especially the vegetarian diets, if you're not monitoring and you're eating a really poor diet and you're vegetarian, you will crave chocolate, probably, because chocolate's a great source of iron. So there's the physical aspect of that, and there's also the psychedelic effects of chocolate, which we've all heard about. The increased PEA in the brain, which helps to stimulate dopamine, which helps to make us feel good and feel happy and woohoo, and this has been touted in a lot of medical studies, and nutritionists have said that this is a really healthy thing. This is a way that we can naturally be happier, and that we can, without having sex, we can get the benefits right there. And that has kind of a dangerous, that's walking right on the edge there. And what I'll share with you about chocolate is that it's my personal experience being an intuitive that when I have chocolate, my intuition shuts off. I can't access a whole lot. I feel very wishy-washy, and I'm not sure about what I am getting intuitively. And so chocolate, because it really does stimulate the brain, it's an overstimulant. So anything that's a stimulant will also naturally, well, I don't know if it's naturally, will also shut off intuition. Because chocolate is very stimulating to the brain. So it's difficult for us to focus when we're being stimulated, right? And not only that, but chocolate also clouds the chakras. So when people say that, oh, I use chocolate or I eat a lot of chocolate because it makes me feel more intuitive, there's a piece to that that's true, because chocolate has a lot of health benefits. So your body will feel better, which might open up your intuition. However, it also, like I said, clouds the chakras. It overstimulates the brain with too many chemicals. And it's just not something you want to do before a reading. I'm not saying don't eat chocolate. I eat chocolate. I eat it at the end of the day. And I have found that if I do that, the next day I can wake up and use my intuition and I'm fine. It takes about 8 to 10 hours to really wear off from the effects of chocolate. And so of course, go out and enjoy chocolate. You just might not want to have it for breakfast. You don't want to start your day with your intuition being muddled. Now, the next stimulant is probably the next most addictive substance that people use, and it's caffeine. Coffee, tea, green tea, things like that. Caffeine is, like all of us know, is very stimulating. It's stimulating on lots of different levels for our body. And just like chocolate, it's too much. It's too much for us to really be able to tap in and listen to that still, small voice. So caffeine is very, is something you want to think about. And a lot of people, and I did this for years too, have caffeine in the morning. Because we're tired, we have something like coffee or green tea or black tea or Pepsi or whatever it is that has caffeine in it because we want to wake up. Which is a whole other, that could be a whole other show, but why do we feel when you wake up that you don't feel ready for your day? That you can't wake up, that you feel like you need something outside of yourself to wake up? And actually, Doreen Virtue, who we all love here at Realms Radio, She's just such an inspiration, and I dearly love her. Love you, Doreen, if you're listening. she says that is caused by people waking up too late. And I thought, that's interesting. Well, if I wake up at 7 a.m., that's early. And she says, no. People are supposed to be in alignment with their surroundings and their environment. Their circadian rhythms are designed to be in the flow with the sun, with the rising and the setting of the sun. So you'll notice, like on those mornings, you may have gone to the airport really, really, really early, and you're waking up and the sun is rising, or the sun is just dawn, and the sun is just barely coming up, and you're looking at it. You're not looking at the sun, of course. You're just looking at the dawn, but the light's coming into your eyes and into your retina. You naturally feel awake. You feel more inspired. You might sleep a bit on the plane, but it's not like waking up after 4 hours of sleep in your home and dawdling around, never going outside and going back to bed. It's totally different. And the same is also true with the sunset. So if you go outside and you watch the sunset, imagine yourself now watching a gorgeous, glorious sunset. There's pink, there's orange, and it's setting, and it's so beautiful. You naturally feel calm. You feel like you might want to get ready for bed. It's calming you down. So then you're ready to go to bed. So then the next morning you wake up with the sun, you get all energized and inspired. So that's what a lot of people are using in our culture for energy. Instead of getting it from the sun, and also a lot of us have been eating really unhealthy, so we don't have energy because we just don't have the right nutrients to make energy, because when the body's functioning well, it's naturally energized even without the sun. Those are some foods that you'd really want to avoid is, again, cacao or chocolate, refined foods, drugs, both psychedelic and pharmaceutical, and animal products. And even if you just start there, even if you just start with going vegan, I'll share, when I went vegan, for the first time, that's when all of my intuition and my intuitive gifts opened up. I was like, wow, I didn't know I was so intuitive right when I went vegan. And from that point on, I've basically been intuitive ever since. And it's only been when I've reintroduced a lot of dairy. I still never went back to meat. But it's when I've reintroduced a lot of dairy that my intuition got kind of muddled, and I was eating a lot of eggs and things like that. My intuition got a little muddled. And so if that's something you're interested in, you may want to just do some research and take some really great methylcobalamin vitamin B12, because there's really no other source for that unless you eat a lot of spirulina. And probably take some iron too, just so that you're not craving meat or craving anything like that. So, in addition, I just want to say one quick shout out to some foods that you may want to avoid with intuition. And these are two superfoods that are really delicious that you may or may not have heard of. They're maca and mesquite. I believe they're both roots from South America. And they're wonderful, and they have a lot of, similar to chocolate or cacao, they have a lot of amazing health properties, but they also overstimulate the brain and the body and shut down intuition, I have found. So just by avoiding all of those foods, you can really start to implement and foster natural intuition. Now, what if you want to take it a step further? If you want to be as intuitive as you can be, which is how I live my life, what do you eat? What does that look like? What kind of foods naturally open up intuition? And the answer is simple. And the answer is growing back in your garden. And the answer is growing on those trees in the tropics. The answer is fresh, uncooked food. What does that mean? That means things like apples and bananas and dates and carrots and lettuce and nuts and sprouted grains and things like that that are full of life. Because what happens when we cook things or when we freeze things or when we do anything that would cause life to die, like, could you survive being boiled? No, you would die. Could you survive being in a freezer? No, you would die. Because life dies. Life can't exist in a can. Life can't exist in a box. Life can only exist as it exists. So eating foods that have life force energy, that still have the energy of the sun in them. David Wolf has a great book called The Sun Food Diet Success System, where you can learn about raw foods and the incredible healing powers that it has. Not only that, but these foods, on a scientific level, have at least 2 to 3 times the nutrient density as cooked foods. And a whole other array of things that science hasn't really figured out yet. And people have healed diabetes in 30 days. People have healed diabetes in 30 days, or reversed diabetes in 30 days, going on a raw food diet. That's it, 30 days, and no more diabetes. So why isn't this everywhere? Why don't we talk about this all the time? I don't know. I'm talking about it now. And what eating this way does, and I'm not even saying eating this way all the time, but eating, even if you just try to incorporate more of these in your diet, how can you easily start to eat more raw foods? Can you have a salad for lunch? Can you have a salad every day for lunch? Or a salad for dinner? Or fruit for breakfast? That's a really good one. And it's delicious, because we all like sweets in the morning. And eating this way really helps to open up your intuition. I'll also say that one thing that a lot of raw foodists do is they eat a lot of fat. And that will also help to turn off intuition if you eat too much fat. And so you don't want to be like, if you're going to be doing the raw thing, you don't want to be eating like coconuts and avocados and oil and everything all the time, and nuts and nuts and nuts, like a lot of raw food people do to get their nutrients. You probably want to get most of your calories and most of your nutrients from fruit. I read this really great book called The 80-10-10 Diet, and I have resisted reading it for so long because I just thought it was had a ridiculous title, and I judged it. But once I opened it up and looked at it, the author talks about how humans are frugivores. We're not fruitarians. We're frugivores, like apes. So apes eat a diet of about, I don't remember what he said actually. They eat, the majority of their diet's fruit, and then they also eat grasses and leaves, and then 1% of their diet is animal-based. So 1% of their diet is insects and meat. But they don't eat that very often. What they eat the majority of the time is fruits and grasses, and fruits, or fruits and vegetables, how you could look at that in our diet. So eating a diet of, gosh, 80% fruits and the rest vegetables would be great. And like, wow, what does that look like? Yeah, that means you wake up and you have fruit for breakfast. I put some green powder on there, put some chlorella for some protein. At lunch I have a bunch of bananas and dates with some kelp powder, which doesn't taste very good by itself, but when you mix it with some bananas and dates, gosh, it tastes delicious. And that's where I get my protein from, is from algaes. And then for dinner I have a huge big salad with a bunch of seaweed. And gosh, let me just say that my body is so in love with me right now. It's just, it's glowing. It's glowing, glowing, glowing. And the natural side benefit of eating a lot of raw living foods is it helps to maintain the channel of intuition. And if you think about it this way, like, wow, what if we were supposed to eat this way all the time? Out in nature, we'd be eating a lot more raw foods. We might not cook really at all, just because maybe we can't start a fire if we don't know how. We'd be eating apples, we'd be eating oranges. When you see fruit, it is enticing to the eye, it's enticing to the smell, and it's even enticing to hold it. Your mouth salivates at the smell of a peach, versus, like I said in the beginning, seeing a rabbit wander. Whereas, like, a carnivore sees a rabbit wander, and it gets excited, and it thinks, like, oh, yum, that's, I'm ready to eat. Or an anteater gets excited when it sees ants. But we don't, because I believe that we're not really supposed to eat that. We're not supposed to eat things like dairy and eggs. And of course they taste good when they're cooked and they're created and manufactured in a certain way. But they're really just not, they're really not really meant for our bodies. So it's really about less engineering and more about allowing the kind of diet that works really great for you to come through. And, you know, for the longest time I did breakfast and lunch raw and ate a cooked dinner, and that felt so good. It just felt like exactly where I was at. And now I'm actually at a point where I'm pretty much 100% raw, with the exception of a dressing that I'll have on my salad. I still go to the store and buy some kind of dressing that I like, which I think is okay. It's important to remember to do things in incremental steps. So really eating foods that are alive and living is great. Also, looking at your water. If you're drinking tap water is full of toxins, and it's just chock full of crap that people don't need. So if you're ingesting stuff like that, that can actually shut off your intuition and cause a lot of illness in your body. So basically, what my diet looks like when I'm intuitive is I eat really light, and I eat a lot of fruit, and I also eat a lot of protein from algaes to offset the sugars in the fruit, so my blood sugar state can stabilize and I can have energy and I can think, because you need protein too. You can't just eat fruit. You've got to have protein in there too, and algaes combine really well with fruit. So you can also learn about food combining and lots of other great stuff in the book, The Body Ecology Diet, which is a great book for rebuilding your body's ecology, and it's a great way to learn about food combining and how that can really serve you. Because if you're eating a bunch of fats and fruits together, and nuts and seeds and fruits together, your body isn't going to be happy, because it's not going to digest those really at all. So that's going to steal your intuitive powers away from you. So this is really important to note, that we stay grounded and in our bodies and feel really good while we're in our bodies to access our intuition. Whenever people are gaining weight, that's almost always a sign that they're ungrounded and they're actually trying to ground themselves with their weight. For example, what grounded looks like is I'm present with my body and with my emotions. So someone who is not wanting to deal with their emotions, let's just take, for example, the classic breakup scene where guy breaks up with girl, girl's sad, is lonely, goes out, gets some ice cream, and starts eating the ice cream. If she keeps doing that, she's going to gain weight, because she's not actually being grounded. She's trying to, what we do when we do that is we're trying to avoid, just like we were talking about earlier in the show, we're trying to avoid our emotions, and we're trying to get something that tastes good to kind of distract us from what we really want to deal with, which is, gosh, I feel so lonely right now, and I feel so sad. Because human beings, as human beings, we're really designed to move towards pleasure and not towards pain, but really by moving into our pain is when we can feel it. Just like, listen to last week's show in the archives, the pathway of forgiveness. You know, we have to feel, then we can heal, and then we can forgive. And if we don't do that, we're gonna find other ways to feel grounded in our bodies, which would include gaining weight. So that's why it's really great to think about what you're feeling before you eat, or before you do anything that you even think you have a slight chance of being addicted to, because chances are good that, gosh, you probably do. But no worries, it's all perfect. I'm going to start seeing that more here on the show. It's all perfect wherever you're at. I really encourage you to not judge yourself and not beat yourself up and not make yourself wrong, because that doesn't solve anything. In fact, that only makes things worse. So be easy with yourself. Be gentle with yourself. Love yourself. It's great that you're listening to this show right now and you're expanding your consciousness, and maybe you want to make some changes in your diet, or, you know, maybe you're not sure. But at the same time, don't beat yourself up. It's okay. We're all doing this together. We're here to create a new earth together, and we don't want to create a new earth where we're all beating ourselves up. That just wouldn't be a good time. So now we're going to get into our meditation. So I invite you to find a comfortable place. Get comfortable in your body. Take a deep breath in. Breathe out. Becoming present with your body. When you place your attention in your body, what do you feel? Don't run from it, even if it feels uncomfortable or it feels like you want to cry or you're sad. That's okay. That's okay. We're providing the space for that here. Continuing to breathe, because breathing helps us to be grounded. It helps us to be present and in our bodies. Breathing in and out, the very life force of spirit in and through us. Asking your higher self now to come forward and compassionately share with you any changes about your diet or your lifestyle in general. That is very crucial for you to know right now. Listening to what your higher self is saying to you, any messages you get, the first thing that comes to your mind, you may get flooded with information, or you may not know yet, but it's still holding space, just listening, not trying to create anything. Just simply listening to your higher self, which is you. This is you. This is you. Are there parts of your diet that are ready to go? Have you intuitively been feeling like certain foods you're ready to do without? If so, ask your higher self for confirmation. Notice what you feel, what you hear, what you see, and what you know. Because you know deep down inside. You know. It's nothing new. Breathing in and out. Asking your higher self which foods are aligned for you to eat, or what does your diet look like? What does your perfect and ultimate diet for turning on and accessing your intuition? What does that look like? What does it feel like? What can your higher self tell you about that? What can you know about that? Receiving any and all messages. Continuing to breathe deeply from your diaphragm, your belly area. And any guidance you receive around your new diet or the diet that the universe would love to see you implementing, taking a moment and realizing that in some way, shape, or form is an answer to your prayers. It is what you've been asking for. It is the next step for you to take on your journey of self-growth, self-discovery and purification. Asking your higher self if there's anything else that you need to know about your diet, your lifestyle, sleeping patterns, anything, anything in regards to your health, or your intuition, and turning on and accessing your intuition, what do you need to know? Asking your higher self to download into your conscious mind exactly what you need to know, so that you know. Calling in signs from the universe to show you. Asking the universe for complete and utter signs that, yes, this is the right path. Overhearing conversations, seeing omens, seeing that book over and over again. Absolute assurance, and the clarity for you to really know that when you see that sign, it is a message for you and what it's about and what to do about it. Clearly know. From this point on, you have guides, calling in guides from Source, that are perfectly aligned for you from now until for the rest of your life, for the rest of all of your lifetimes, to send you the perfect guides, asking Source to send you the perfect guides to help you and guide you for the perfect diet, to foster your intuition, helping you to be all that you can be intuitively. Clearly hearing the guidance, clearly knowing what you need to do, clearly and firmly cementing within your being that this is your path. This is absolutely your path. Thanking Source. Thanking your new guides that are with you for the rest of your life and all future lifetimes. Going to help you to be all that you can be intuitively. Guide you to the perfect diet, gently but surely. Guide you to the perfect methodologies and practitioners. Assisting your transformation here in this earth plane. And helping you to facilitate your own ascension into your own divine mastery. And so it is. Thanking God, thanking Spirit, Universe, Light Beings, Guides, Higher Self, just all, thanking all, being with you here today. And you can slowly begin to open up your eyes and come back to reality. We went to some Akashic record land there, and it was wonderful, but now we're here back in the earth plane, and we've got to make some decisions and some practical adjustments to our lifestyle, and that's okay. That's okay. We can take it step by step and moment by moment. We don't have to do it all at once. Absolutely not. And knowing that that's okay. So, in fact, that's that's more than okay. It's great. It's great. So, gosh, I so hope you enjoyed this show today. This has been a show that I've been wanting to do for quite some time, just sharing with people all about how they can access their intuition. And if you would like more clarity and more transformation with this, I'm really excited to be announcing that I'm starting a class, and hopefully it's going to be launching April 18th, And right now it's called Cosmic Sorcery. And this class is really about doing just that. It's about accessing your divine intelligence and reawakening it so that you live your life this way and that you are intuitive everywhere you go. And I will train you either in person if you live here in the San Francisco Bay Area, or over the internet wherever you are. And you can learn to do intuitive readings. You can learn to give accurate and complete and utter perfectly divine readings for people, and also just doing some really fun things like manipulating the weather and all of this wonderful cosmic stuff. So I'm sure I'm going to be talking a lot more about that, but right now it's in the beginning stages and I'm putting it all together. So you can definitely check that out on my personal website, which is www.realmzofhealing.com, and that's Realmz with a Z, so that's Realmz of healing.com. And you can learn all about me and discover some of my services, or book a reading with me if you like. I can help you to find your life's purpose, if a particular relationship is aligned for you, if something is really crucial for you to know about your diet, or really about anything. I can give you clarity on that, and I can serve as that bridge if you're needing some assistance in that arena. So you can do that on my website, realmzofhealing.com. So thank you for listening to this show. I encourage you to keep in contact with me somehow, either on Facebook or through contacting me through the Realmz Radio site on our contact page. You can contact me there. And let me know what your plans are for your diet or for anything. I encourage you to stay connected with me on the Realmz Radio Facebook fan page. I make most of the posts on there, so if you see a post on there and it doesn't say Love Lizzie Be Love or Love Anu or Love Tana, it's me. I want to really facilitate and create this community together with you, you're such a valuable part of this community. So please reach out, don't be shy, contact me one way or another, and just let me know, let me get to know you on a personal level. I'm really committed to that, and that's what we all are committed here on Realmz Radio. So with that, my darlings, I bid you adieu. I love you, and we are really creating this new earth together, right here, right now. There's no mistake. Blessings, namaste, and remember, it is all perfect.
Realmz Radio, where spirit rocks. Would you like to receive empowerment, help, and healing from heaven and the angelic realms? Schedule your one-on-one intuitive reading with me, Tana Newberry, the Angel Gal, and hear from all of your heavenly helpers and loved ones in spirit. Whether you're seeking guidance about your career, your love life, your life purpose, or anything else that can bring you more peace and more joy, I am happy to help. Learn more about my services and how to receive a free consultation at my website, www.theangelgal.com. And don't forget to tune into my show, Dedicate This Day, Monday through Thursday, 9:30 a.m. and 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, right here on Realmz Radio.